receive his sight and the Holy Ghost. The Bible said that Ananias started talking like church people today. Said, Lord, I know you're not going to save him. He persecuted the saints. He stoned the saints. He's a devil. How in the world are you going to save a gangster like him? The Lord said, listen, let me tell you something. I have chosen him. Let me tell you something. In this hour, you better be careful by saying who God can and cannot use. Just because you've been in the church all your life don't mean you're the qualified one. God will take a prostitute off the street and make her a prophetess. He'll take a man that's a dope dealer and turn him into a bishop. God is such a God that he can take a dirty sinner and change his life around. I don't care who you are in this place, God can change your life. He said, go and lay your hand on him. I've chosen him. When Ananias gets in the house, he sees Saul sitting there blind. He said, the Lord sent me here to lay hands on you. But this is what I love. When we're first introduced to Saul, they don't give him a handle. They just call him Saul. Maybe if you're going to call him anything, he's a persecutor. He's a liar. He's a murderer. Hallelujah. But after God transforms him, gives him a vision, no longer is he persecutor Saul. Not only is he killer Saul, but when Ananias came in the house, he said, brother Saul. I know we don't like to say that anymore, but I grew up in a time when we greeted one another. We said, brother or sister. And I think we need to get back to that. Because at the end of the day, we're all in the family of God. It doesn't matter where you came from. It's all about where you are right now and where God is going to take you. He said, brother Saul, God sent me here to lay hands on you that you might receive your sight and that you might receive the Holy Ghost. And when Ananias laid his hands on Saul, the Bible said some other transformation started happening. It looked like scales fell off of his eyes. And I came to tell somebody today that you may have been in a blind condition. Looked like you couldn't see things getting better for you. But God told me to tell you that when you stepped up and went to West Angeles on today, the Holy Ghost ophthalmologist, the Holy Ghost optometrist is getting ready to perform surgery on your eyes. Why don't you lay your hand on your eyes and say, Lord, open up mine eyes so that I may see. The Bible says that the scales fell off of his eyes and he received the Holy Ghost. I need to tell you one last thing, that when your eyes come open, you can experience the power of the Holy Ghost. I see some of you in this room, and God told me to tell you that he's getting ready to take the blinders off. The devil showed you your death and defeat. He told you you'll never be delivered. Your family would never get better. Your ministry would never take off. Your business would never be successful. But the devil is a liar. God's getting ready to turn things around for your favor. Shake somebody's hand like you're about to shake it off and say, neighbor, tell them this is your day for the blinders to come off. I can see my healing. I can see my deliverance. I can see my transformation. The devil had me bound, had me held back. Told you'll be broke, busted, and disgusted for the rest of your days. But the devil is a liar. God's getting ready to break you out of what had you held hostage. Get ready for dramatic changes in your mind. Get ready for dramatic changes in your family. But the key is you got to see it. And if you don't see it before you see it, you'll never see it. I may not be able to touch it in the natural right now, but I see something. Thank you, Bishop Blake. Thank you for that word, that I see you in the future, and you look much better than you look right now. Shake somebody's hand and say, neighbor, I see you in the future, and you look much better than you look right now. Yes, the devil thought he had you hemmed in, had you boxed in, but I can see my myself going higher, forgetting those things which are behind me, and I'm reaching for those things which are before me. I press toward the mark, toward the prize of a high calling in Christ Jesus. Is there anybody here that want to go higher? Throw your head back, throw your hand up, and say, Lord, take me higher. I want to go higher in my life. I want to go higher in my mind. I've been changed, I've been transformed, and I've got a feeling that everything is gonna be all right. Shake somebody's hand and say, neighbor, you don't know how rough it's been. Tell them, you don't know how tough it's been. Tell them, I almost threw in the towel, but tell them, I saw something. And right now, I've got a feeling that everything is gonna be all right in my home, all right on my job, all right in my marriage. The devil don't like it, but too late, devil, I can see it. I can see it. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. I gotta quit, but I'm reminded, growing up in my grandfather's church, Bishop, we had a preacher in my grandfather's church, and when the anointing would fall on him, he'd jump out of his seat and say, up, I see God, yonder come Jesus. And I'm just wondering today, is there anybody here that can see God? It's been rough, but can you see God? I dare you to point your hand and say, I see God, yonder come Jesus, yonder come Jesus. He's coming to save you, he's coming to deliver you, he's coming to deliver you. Yes, and if you can see it, don't wait till the battle is over, but shout. Shout. Shout right now. I need somebody here that believe God for real. How many people God has given you a vision? Let me see you wave your hand. Anybody believe it's coming to pass? When I count to three in this place, I want you to act. How are you going to act when what God shows you come to pass? Now I can tell how great your vision is by how your reaction will be. When I count to three, if you believe that God's going to bring it to pass, I want you to jump on your feet and say, it's coming to pass, and praise God like it's already done. You ready? One, two, three, come on and praise. Tell somebody that. Come on, tell them. it look much better. Tell somebody else, I see you in the future, and you look much better. Now if you believe it, praise him. Send up another shout in this place. Shout. Yeah, nah, 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 nah.